I'll begin with prayers. Om Jnanatimirandasya Jnananjanashalakaya Chakshurunmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha Namo Vishnupadaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharane Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshakarane वांछाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्येव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवाचार्य गौरभक्तवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे मूकं करोति वाचालं पुनः गायति गिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वंदे श्री गुरो दीनतारिणम् So let's do a quick recap of yesterday. So last time we saw how I put the topic of Advent of Srimad Bhagavatam. I'll just do a quick revision in 2 minutes and then we'll proceed ahead. Everybody see the screen?
Yes, Prabhuji.
Yes, Prabhuji.
So we saw how Ashwatthama wanted to kill Parikshit Maharaj and Lord Krishna protected Parikshit Maharaj by entering into the womb of Uttara. Uttara was carrying Parikshit, and Parikshit was the last person in the dynasty of the Pandavas. And if Parikshit is killed, then whole Pandavamsha or Kuruvamsha is only destroyed. So Uttara goes running to Krishna, and then Krishna protects Parikshit Maharaj by going into the womb and encircling in the womb and protecting Parikshit Maharaj by absorbing the heat of Brahmastra. So because Parikshit Maharaj was searching for that person who protected him in the womb, so his name became Parikshit because he was doing Pariksha constantly. So then Krishna goes and catches, Krishna and Arjuna both go and they catch Ashwatthama and they bring him and they put him in front of Draupadi. And then Draupadi, being a good lady, she felt that if you kill Ashwatthama, then Ashwatthama's mother will feel pain. So better not kill him. So let's forgive him. Like that she said. And then he was forgiven. But Bhima was not happy. Bhima wanted him dead. So then Krishna told Arjuna, you kill him, but don't kill him. So both things you have to do. So you kill him means what? You kill him by insulting him and leave him with his life. So he took off the money and shaved off his head. She cut off his hair. And in this way, he insulted Ashwatthama and actually left him. Right. So then, actually after he was released, then he again shot a Brahmastra and then Parikshit Maharaj was protected by the Lord. Right. Before this, actually, the 5 sons of Pandavas were killed. And then Parikshit Maharaj's attempt to kill him was made. And then Lord protected him. And then Parikshit Maharaj started ruling the kingdom. He ruled the kingdom in such a way that even Kali could not do anything. Kali could not do any influence in the kingdom. So powerful he was. So he even Kali ko nigraha kiya unhone. So that was that much power he had. Actually, Kali Yuga began. Kali wanted to exhibit his power, but as long as Krishna was present, Kali could not do anything. When Krishna left, then Kali wanted to exhibit, but Parikshit Maharaj did not allow him to do anything. So in this way, Parikshit Maharaj was extremely powerful. So that's what we can learn from this pastime. Then Kali enters and he was beating the cow and bull, and Parikshit Maharaj punished him. Kali begs forgiveness, and he gave him 4 places to stay, where people are eating meat, they're having illicit sex, and they're having gold, and intoxication and gambling. Actually, 4 places were given, these 4 places, meat eating, illicit sex, intoxication, gambling. But Parikshit, in Parikshit Maharaj's kingdom, such place was not existing only. So then he gave him a place of gold. Wherever gold is there, you stay there. That's what was told. So then Kali Raj stayed in gold, because wherever gold is there, there is a chance of committing crime. Yes. And then you see here, this is what we have to discuss today. So once upon a time, when Parikshit Maharaj was going into the forest, he was actually hunting. Actually, Kshatriyas are allowed to hunt because they have to fight in the battle. So in order to do some practice, they have to do hunting. So Parikshit Maharaj went into the forest and he felt very thirsty. Pyaas lag gaya. So because he was very thirsty, he came into the ashram of one sage. His name was Shamika Rishi. Shamika Rishi was sitting and doing tapasya. And then Parikshit Maharaj felt very thirsty. So he came inside, but sage did not see him. And Parikshit Maharaj became angry. Actually, Parikshit Maharaj is such a great king that there's some chat coming. Hare Krishna, Ankit is saying Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Ankit. So he was such a great king that he was a samrat, Chakravarti samrat. Chakravarti samrat matlab, all the kings are under his control. That is Chakravarti samrat. So because he was such a great king, and he deserved some welcome and reception. So Parikshit Maharaj was also very thirsty. So he became very angry. Then there was some snake, dead snake nearby. He put it on the shoulder of, on the neck of Shamik Rishi. And Shamik Rishi, he was sitting in Samadhi. So he did not mind it. He did not even come to know something is there. But Parikshit Maharaj's son, Shamik Rishi's son, his name was Shringi. And he was playing nearby with his friends, and he was just 5-year-old child. And this child, he comes to know that Parikshit has put a snake on the neck. And Shringi, using his tapobal, because he was a Brahmana, he had that strength. So he touches water, touches his thread, and then he curses. He pronounces a curse on this king. And he curses, saying that, in 7 days, you will die. A snake bird will come. A snake which is having wings. That's called Takshaka. Takshaka will come and it will bite you and you will die. So that's what he said. So because of that, Shringi pronounced this curse. And actually, he was not very intelligent. Ajara said that he was very dull-minded because he did not know to whom he is cursing. Right, we have to know the history of a person before cursing him. Parikshit Maharaj was such a great king, such a pious king. And what wrong he had done. He had not done anything wrong as such. Right, it was a small thing he had done. Instead of putting anything, he was just angry. He could have killed also, but he did not, because he respected Brahmanas very much. And he was thirsty and there was no water available. So then he was a little upset. And then he put something on the neck of Shamika Rishi. But Shringi took it very seriously. And then he cursed. And he comes back to his hermitage. Shringi comes back to his hermitage of his father. And he sees the dead snake on his father's neck. And he starts crying. Father, what has happened to you? Why has he, king, put this snake around you? I have cursed him to die in 7 days. Like that, Shringi says to Shamika. And Shamika opens his eyes. And he sees the snake and just brushes it away. He puts it off. He doesn't take it very seriously because he was a very self-controlled, Brahman realized personality. So he didn't take it very seriously. So then he tells to Shringi, why did you curse him? Don't you know Parikshit Maharaj is such an elevated personality? Whatever he does, we should not take it, means whatever wrong he may do to us, we should not take it seriously because that will be empowered by the Lord. Parikshit is a great devotee, Mahabhagavata, and whatever he does is sanctioned by the Lord. So this also must have been sanctioned by the Lord. So you should not have cursed. You are a not very intelligent child. It's like this. He chastises Sringi. Such a great king. If you are cursing the king to die, if the king dies, then what will happen to the kingdom? Who will take care of the kingdom? Why did you do this? Because Parikshit Maharaj is the king, he is controlling the entire planet. So nobody is doing any sinful activities. He is such a powerful king. And his name is Vishnu Rat. He was personally protected by Lord Vishnu. That's why he's called as Vishnu Rat. So one should know before cursing that he is such a great personality. And then he chastises Sringi and he feels very upset. And he didn't have his face. He could not go to Parikshit Maharaj to beg forgiveness. And sometimes when somebody makes a mistake, we cannot show the face also to others, isn't it? इतना वो गलती इतना सिली या इतना बड़ा होता है, बड़ा भी मिस्टेक हो या सिली भी मिस्टेक हो, चेहरा दिखा नहीं सकते किसी को. सो देन हियर सच ए ग्रेव मिस्टेक हैड हैपेंड. सो ही वाज थिंकिंग, हाउ कैन आई गो एंड बेग फॉरगिवनेस फ्रॉम परीक्षित महाराज. आई कैनॉट बेग फॉरगिवनेस, आई डोंट हैव द स्ट्रेंथ टू डू दैट. सो लेट मी प्रे टू द लॉर्ड. सो शमिक ऋषि ही ऑफर्स प्रेयर्स टू द लॉर्ड सेइंग, ओ लॉर्ड, please forgive my son Sringi because he has done this big blunder. So he requests for forgiven. Okay, so now we will read a particular section from Srimad Bhagavatam. Some shlokas which will help us to give better understanding. So Parikshit Maharaj was cursed to die in 7 days, and let's see how Parikshit Maharaj takes this curse. So this is Canto 1, Chapter 18. So Hare Krishna, we just welcome devotees who have joined just now. I think Vaishali Mataji and Amit, Rohit, Ashutosh, they are joining us right now.
Prabhuji, may I ask a question?
Yes, Rahul.
For Parikshit Maharaj to be so elevated person to do such silly thing, as to put the snake around the sage. Yeah, how come it is? A thing which is accepted by us.
Yeah.
Even though he is thirsty, he should have called out the sage or do something else.
Mm.
But is it not wrong to do such a thing?
Yes, it is wrong to do such a thing. But in this case, it was the will of the Lord, because Lord had a plan. He wanted to use Parikshit as an instrument to make Srimad Bhagavatam appear, by which the whole world can get benefited. So because of that, he wanted Parikshit, Lord inspired Parikshit to put a snake on him, and then the curse will be pronounced. So that was the reason. Okay. Otherwise, if this episode is not happening, then what happens? Bhagavatam will not come. So he wanted Srimad Bhagavatam to appear. So some activities are inspired by the Lord, especially in these cases. What is the proof? Proof is that child who could tolerate the heat of Brahmastra, can't he tolerate the thirst? That person who did not drink water for 7 days while hearing Srimad Bhagavatam, that will come in the future, he had that much capacity to be without drinking water or eating continuously for 7 days. Can't he tolerate that thirst? So like this, Acharyas explain that he had the capacity to tolerate, but that severe thirst was inspired by the Supreme Lord. So because of which he put the snake, and eventually the curse came. And when the curse came, how he reciprocated to the curse, that is a lesson for us. Right? Because death is going to come to anybody. So death is going to come. Death is now pronounced for Parikshit Maharaj to die in 7 days. Now for us also, death is going to come. Now, how that death will come, we don't know. So we have to get ready. So the important question here is how Parikshit Maharaj responded to this curse. So from that we can know how to prepare for that time, the testing time when the death will come in our life. Right? Right, Rahul?
Yes, Prabhuji. Understood.
So the answer is that it was the plan of the Lord for a higher purpose. Okay. Similarly, Arjuna was also put in confusion. Now, Arjuna, how can he fall into confusion in the beginning of Bhagavad Gita? He had already defeated the Kauravas in Virata. He had even defeated the Devatas. He had defeated so many Rakshasas, Yakshas in the battle. So how can he get bewildered while fighting with humans on the battlefield of Kurukshetra? So this was also inspired, that confusion was also inspired with the Lord to use Arjuna as an instrument to teach us Bhagavad Gita. To teach you and me Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna agreed to play the role of a confused person. Similarly, in order to teach all of us, Parikshit Maharaj agreed to be the instrument to do such an activity to teach us a lesson. Okay, so that's how we have to understand this. Okay. So here, Shamika Rishi is telling, the Emperor Parikshit is a pious king. He is highly celebrated and is first class devotee of the personality of Godhead. He is a saint amongst royalty. Means he is a Raja Rishi. He is saint also and is a king also. And he has performed many horse sacrifices, Ashwamedha Yajnas. When such a king is tired and fatigued, being stricken with hunger and thirst, he does not at all deserve to be cursed. See, the Shamika Rishi himself is telling this verse. He doesn't deserve to be, because he is a celebrated personality, he is a Raja Rishi, he is a great king, a person of such a high stature. So it should not be taken seriously. Apapeshu swabhrityeshu bale na pakva buddhina papam kritam tad bhagavan sarvatma kshantum arhati. Then the Rishi prayed to the all-pervading personality of Godhead to pardon his immature boy who had no intelligence and who committed the great sin of cursing a person who was completely free from all sins, who was subordinate and who deserved to be protected. Right? So father is praying for the protection of son, because here the Parikshit Maharaj was cursed, but Parikshit Maharaj will be protected by the Lord. Shambhika Rishi is thinking, because he was already protected before. Now also Lord will protect him from the curse. So it's not a problem. But problem is for my son, because my son has offended Parikshit Maharaj, who is a great personality. So let him be forgiven. So that's what Shambhika Rishi is telling here to the Supreme Lord. He's praying to the Supreme Lord in this way. So similarly, sometimes one may make some mistakes, then he has to pray to the Supreme Lord for protection. So he asks for protection, and then yeah, he's telling this important verse. Tiraskrita vipralabdha shapta kshipta hatapi nasyatat pratikurvanti tadbhakta prabhavopihi. Can somebody read this translation?
The devotees of the Lord are so forbearing that even though they are defamed, cheated, cursed, disturbed, neglected or even killed, they are never inclined to avenge themselves.
Yeah. So Parikshit Maharaj, he is such a great personality that even though he may be neglected, defamed, even killed or cursed, they will not retaliate. Such tolerance Parikshit Maharaj has got. So you have made a big mistake, Sringi, like that. The sage is telling him. So like this, it goes on, and it will go to the shloka where Parikshit Maharaj is thinking. Yeah, that comes in the next chapter, second verse. So let's see one or two verses of how Parikshit Maharaj is responding to this curse, and then we will see what he did after he got this curse, and then how he heard Srimad Bhagavatam from Sukadeva Goswami. That will be briefly our topic of discussion today. And we'll try to end by 5:30 because we have another program at 6 o'clock. So we'll try to end this program at 5:30. Hey, can somebody read this translation? King Parikshit thought. Yes, Rohit.
King Parikshit thought, due to my neglecting the injunction of the Supreme Lord, I must certainly expect some difficulty to overcome me in the near future. I now desire without reservation that calamity come now, for in this way I may be freed from the sinful action and not to commit such an offense again.
He said, I have neglected, means I have insulted a Brahmana. And Parikshit Maharaj is thinking in his mind, I have insulted a Brahmana. Surely some reaction is going to come. Let it come. He says, so let it come on me only, not on others. So generally, if a person makes mistake, not only he gets affected, but people who are dependent on him, they also get affected. Like for example, if in a family, the husband makes a mistake, right? He does some blunder. Then what happens? Whole family gets affected, not just one person. Similarly, here king is making a mistake, then his queens, his children, then other common citizens who are connected to him, they will also get affected, right? Because he is a great king. So, more greater the person, bigger the influence. So, and the mistake he makes will also have greater influence. So, that's why Parikshit Maharaj being repentant, right? Although it was not a very big mistake, but he considered it as a very big mistake. Right. So you have to analyze from two angles of vision. From Shamik Rishi's point of view, it was not a big mistake. It just put a snake. And from Parikshit Maharaj's point of view, later he felt bad. Oh, why did I put the snake on him? So like this, he was feeling bad. And at that time only, when he was feeling like this, one Brahmana comes and tells to Parikshit Maharaj, he gives the news that you have been cursed to die in 7 days. O Parikshit Maharaj, you have been cursed to die in 7 days, and a snake will come and bite you. And that's how Parikshit Maharaj gets the news. And that Brahmana's name is Gauramukha. He gives. Actually, Shamik Rishi only sends, you go and tell Parikshit Maharaj that you have been cursed like this. So after hearing this curse, Parikshit Maharaj feels more repentant. And he says, let the reaction come to me immediately. Let it not wait. So similarly, when somebody makes a mistake, we should be ready to accept the punishment. We should not try to escape the punishment. Because we escape the punishment, then we will only get into trouble. Because we cannot have the rectification. Unless we accept punishment, we cannot get rectified. The problem will persist. Only when we accept our own mistake, then we can overcome that mistake. Right? That punishment has to be accepted. So here, Parikshit was in the mood to accept that punishment. Yeah, please read this next one.
I am uncivilized and sinful due to my neglect of Brahmin culture and God consciousness and cow production. Therefore, I wish that my kingdom and strength and riches burn up immediately by the fire of the Brahmana Vrat, so that in the future I may not be misguided, I may not be guided by such inauspicious attitudes.
Yeah. So he is feeling more repentant here. Let the fire of the Brahmana's curse burn me, he is telling. Then you will see here.
When king, while the king was thus repenting, he received the news of his imminent death, which would be due to the bite of the snake bird, occasioned by the curse spoken by the sage's son. The king accepted this as a good news, for it would be the cause of his indifference towards worldly things.
Yeah. So although such calamity was coming to him, he called it as a good news because it was Virakti Karanam. it will help him to come closer to Krishna and detach him from this material world. So the goal of life is the Atma should connect back to Paramatma, Krishna. We should engage in Krishna's service because we are Krishna's eternal servants. Now here, Parikshit Maharaj, he was a king and he was ruling this kingdom. He had a lot of responsibilities in this material world. Now this curse when he heard that in 7 days he is going to be, he has to leave his body, then he thought, this is also good because I can give up my material responsibilities. I'll hand over my responsibility to my son, and I can prepare for death, and I can go back to Godhead. That's how he thinks. He takes even the calamity to be positive news, and then he prepares for his imminent death. Similarly, in our life also, we may get certain situations which may not be palatable, which may be difficult to digest, right? Right. So, especially when some serious sickness has come, and when the doctor also says that humse kuch hoga nahi, pray to God. So, such kind of situations come where we are helpless and hopeless. In that situation also, we can turn it into positive by thinking that this is, death is a means of coming closer to God. Death is not a painful thing, but it is a means of coming closer to God. The death will unite me with God. So in that way, one can think and prepare oneself for that imminent death. That's what we can learn from Parikshit Maharaj's life. Yeah. Please read this.
Maharaj Parikshit sat down firmly on the banks of the Ganges to concentrate his mind in Krishna consciousness, rejecting all other practices of self-realization, because transcendental loving service to Krishna is the greatest achievement, superseding all other methods.
So he went and sat on the bank of Ganga and he started preparing for his death. It is said that Ganga is the most holiest of the holy rivers. Because Ganga is coming from directly from the lotus feet of Lord Vishnu. When Lord Vamana, he begged 3 steps of land from Bali Maharaj. So Bali Maharaj could give 2 steps of land. One step, Vamandev covered entire earthly planet, and in another step, he covered all the upper planetary systems. So everything in the universe is covered by 2 steps. So when he raised his feet high, the feet, the toes of the thumb, they pierce the covering of the universe. And the water from the layers of the universe, it came and washed the feet of Lord Vamanadeva. And that water came down trickling and came through the heavens and then came to earth. So that water which came down through that means, that's called as Ganga. She is Charanamrit of the Supreme Lord. She is very, very purifying. It is said that she purifies the entire creation just by coming in contact with her. So she came, when she is coming through Akasha, she is called Akasha Ganga. And when she comes to earth in Himalayas, she is called Alakananda. And she flows through the Gangetic plain, right? So she is also called Janavi. Because she was drunk by Janu Rishi and again released. So she's called as Janavi. And then when she enters into Patala, she meets Bay of Bengal and then enters through the channels of the earth to Patala. She's called Patal Ganga. And in Patala, she delivered 60,000 sons of Sagar Maharaj who were burnt by Kapila Maharshi. So in this way, she's purifying from heavenly planets to earthly planets and to even the lower planetary systems. Everything she is purifying. So she is most auspicious river, right? How many of you had got chance to visit Ganga or take bath in Ganga?
Prabhuji, I.
You did? Okay. Wonderful. You're staying near, right? Mm-hmm. Near to Ganga. Yeah. So if you get a chance, you can go sometimes and take bath in holy Ganga.
But Prabhuji, it is now, it becomes very dirty.
Yeah, so because of factories, she is getting polluted.
And Prabhuji, some people are coming there and burning the bodies. While Prabhuji, that, this also makes the river Ganga polluted.
Yeah, yeah. Many causes are there. But whatever, we should try to protect Ganga. So it's up to in the government. Yeah.
So Prabhuji,
but Prabhuji, Haridwar and Gangotri, they are still as it is, because
they are before Delhi. They are Delhi ke baad kuch growth hai.
But those are really good.
So Prabhuji, why they burn the bodies near the river Ganga?
Because Ganga is holy river, so near that place, especially in Banaras and all, they burn the bodies.
Yes, Prabhuji, in Banaras.
Yeah, yeah. So then after that, they put the ashes in Ganga. Because jo bhi Ganga ke sparsh mein aega, contact mein aega, wo mukt ho jayega. To isliye jo bhasm hai, wo Ganga mein dalte. So putting bhasm and all is not a problem in Ganga. But putting chemicals, that is the problem. So one should avoid putting chemicals and soap and factory waste or gutter water. These things are bad. Putting ash or flowers is not a problem because they are organic matter. They'll naturally get decayed and absorbed in the nature. But putting artificial things, that's not good. Hai na? So Ganga ka bahut mahatv hai. So he went on the bank of Ganga and he sat there. Right? So it is said. Yeah. So it's a very beautiful verse. या वै लसत् श्री तुलसी विमिश्रा कृष्णाङ्घ्रिरेणोऽभ्यभिकाम्बुनेत्री पुनाति लोकान् उभयत्र शेषान् कस्तां न सेवेत मरिष्यमाणः. The river Ganges, by which the king sat to fast, carries the most auspicious water, which is mixed with the dust of the lotus feet of the Lord and tulsi leaves. Therefore, that water sanctifies the three worlds inside and outside, and even sanctifies Lord Shiva and other demigods. Consequently, everyone who is destined to die must take shelter of this river. Right? Now, we may not be able to go to this river at the time of death. So what we should do? We can keep Ganga bottle so that if the time of death comes, somebody can put it in our mouth. Right? So generally, every home has got some Ganga jal and some tulsi. Right, and also some pavitra, like dust of Vrindavan or some holy places, it's kept so that one can sprinkle at the time of death, and by that one can get spiritual potency at the time of death. Right, so that's how we can prepare for death. So then, when he was sitting there on the bank of the river, all the great thinkers and sages from all over the universe, they came there. The great personalities, their names are mentioned here. See? Atri, Vashishta, Shavana, Sharadvan, Arishtanemi, Bhrugu, Angira, Parashara, Gadhi. Gadhi Sutta means Vishwamitra. Parushurama, Indra Pramadha, Idmavahu, Medhatiti, Devala, Arishtasena, Bharadvaja, Gautama, Pippala, Maitreya, right? Auravaha, Kasha, Kavachaha, right? Kumbhayoni, Dvaipayana, Vyasadev, and Narada, Bhagavan Narada, the great Narada, they all appeared. So on the scene. Why they appeared? Just to hear, just to see how Parikshit Maharaj is departing. Because they heard the glories of Parikshit Maharaj's birth. Now they wanted to see how Parikshit Maharaj is departing. So to see that, they came. And many, many other sages. Anyecha Devarshi Brahmarshi Varya, Rajarshi Varya, Arunadayascha, right? Nanarshaya Pravaran, very great experts, right? Sametan, Abhyarcha Raja Shirasa Bhavande. Everybody came there, and king offered respects to each and every one of them. See, such great personalities are coming, means Parikshit Maharaj was so famous all over the universe. So like this, the sage standing with folded palms in front of him, and his very, very simple dress. He was just wearing a waist cloth, that's all, on the waist, and he was completely detached. He left all his opulent dress in his kingdom, and he came just with simple dress in front of all of them. Just one piece of cloth he was wearing, that's all. And he says, I'm so thankful. Aho vayam dhanyatama andripanam. I'm so thankful. My life is perfect because all of you have come here to bestow your mercy on me. And he says, it's not because of my qualification, because of my grandfathers, Arjuna and the Pandavas. And because of them, my connection with them, you have come here. I'm so grateful. So he's glorifying his Pandavas and the grandfathers of Parikshit Maharaj. Right? So then he offers beautiful prayers to all of them. Then he says that I am completely surrendered here. Yeah. So can somebody read this translation? It is a very beautiful verse. This shows that he is not afraid of death.
O Brahmanas, just accept me as a completely surrendered soul and let Mother Ganges, the respective of the Lord, representative of the Lord, also accept me in that way. For I have already taken the lotus feet of the Lord into my heart. Let the snake bird or whatever magical thing the Brahmana created bite me at once. I only desire that you all continue singing the deeds of Lord Vishnu.
Right. Gayata Vishnu Gatha. Let whatever may come, let death may come, snake bird may come or anything else may come. I am not afraid. You just speak Krishna's glories to me. I will hear Krishna's glories and I will depart. So at the time of death, we should aspire for this. That let there be somebody who can chant Hare Krishna for me. Let there be somebody who can give some Ganga Jal to me. Let there be somebody who can maybe speak about Krishna or read Krishna book to me. So in this way, one can aspire for that kind of situation. Otherwise, if somebody dies in a place where nobody, no devotee is there, and one is remembering some materialistic things and then he dies, then what happens? He'll be again born in this life in some species. Right? If he is remembering animals, he may become a dog or something. Right? If he is remembering some relatives, he may be born in the same family again. But if he is remembering Krishna, he'll go to Krishna Loka. Right? So that's how one should prepare for death. And Parikshit Maharaj beautifully prays, if I take birth again, in case I don't attain perfection, if I take birth again, punascha bhuyat, if I take birth again, let me have these three things. Bhagavati anante prati, let me have love for Krishna. Prasangascha tadashreshu, let me have friendship with your devotees. Right? Mahatsuyamyam uvayami srishtim, maitrestu sarvatra, let me have friendship with everyone. Namo dvijebhyah, let me have no enmity with anybody. Let me have friendship with all. Let me have association of your devotees. And let me have love for Krishna. These three things he is praying to them. So then he asks some beautiful questions. That what is the duty of a dying man? Right. So then it comes here. Yeah. So let me go to that section. O trustworthy Brahmanas, I now ask you about my immediate duty. Please, after proper deliberation, tell me of the unalloyed truth of everyone in all circumstances, and specifically of those who are just about to die. Right? So unalloyed duty of everyone in all circumstances, and specifically of a person who is about to die. So these two questions were asked by Parikshit Maharaj. Right? So what general people should do and what I should do? I'm about to die now. Can you please tell me? Like this he says. Now, we don't know when we are going to die. So death is maybe far away, but it may be near also. So one should prepare for death, that final moment by preparing. If examination you want to crack nicely, then preparation should be good. If preparation is weak, then examination cannot be proper. So that's why the life is preparation and death is the final exam. And Parikshit Maharaj is teaching us by asking this question that how we should prepare for that death. So after he asked this question, the sages are wondering, Vyasadeva is there, Narada Muni is there, Parashuram is there, and so many great, great personalities are there. Who will answer this question? So like this, there was a little discussion going on amongst themselves because they wanted to choose one person who can answer this. And there are many non-devotees also. There were some karmis, or you can say there are some monists or impersonalists also in that. So different mixture of sages were there, but some were exalted like Vyasadeva and Narada Muni or Parashuram. So at that right moment, one young boy appears there. He was bluish in complexion. His body was well formed. He had beautiful curly locks of black hair. And he was extremely beautiful to look at. And he was just 16 years old. And he was the son of Vyasadeva. His name was Shukadeva Goswami. Shuka. Shuka Muni also they call in South India. He's called Shukadeva. And Shukadeva was Digambara. He didn't wear any clothes. He was because his body itself was a cloth on the soul. And he was completely oblivious to the happenings around him. And he was fully sense controlled. He was a great devotee. He was expert in shastras and fully detached from the material happiness and distresses. So that personality. And when he walked and came into the assembly, Daiva Choditaha, by the will of the Lord, divine will of the Lord, he came there. Because when the curse was pronounced, the Lord inspired Shukadeva Goswami that there is a need for you to go to Parikshit, please go there. So being inspired by the Paramatma in the heart, he came there. So we also, if we desire to attain the Lord very quickly, and Lord sends us right people, right association, right guidance by which we can progress in bhakti. Right? So we should desire. So Brahmanda Brahmite Kona Bhagyavanaji. Guru Krishna Prasadipaya Bhakti Lata Vich. So by the grace of the Lord, one gets a proper guru. So by the grace of Krishna, Parikshit Maharaj gets Shukadeva Maharaj. And when Shukadeva Maharaj came in that assembly, all caught up. But except Narada and Vyasa, because they are very elderly. And Vyasa's guru is Narada. And Shukadeva Maharaj's guru is Vyasadeva. So everybody else stood up, welcomed him. And then they decided, he will speak Srimad Bhagavatam. He will speak the answers to your questions. So in that way, he was chosen. And Parikshit Maharaj, he puts Shukadeva Goswami on an elevated seat. You can see in this photograph. And you can see here. So Shukadeva Goswami, very young. And there's Narada Muni sitting here. Right? And there are other sages also. There's Vyasa and many, many great sages. And Parikshit Maharaj sitting down. And Shukadeva Goswami sitting up. And question answer is happening. Right? So here is a verse describing Shukadeva Goswami. Tatra bhavad bhagavan vyasa putro yadrichhayagam ataman upekshaha alakshalingo nijalabhatushto vritaschabaler avaduta veshaha. All the assembled sages rise from their seat in order to honor Shukadeva Goswami except Vyasa and Narada Muni, who accepted the seat. Sukadeva Goswami appeared like moon in between stars. And all the sages are compared to stars and Sukadeva Goswami is like the moon. Parikshit respected by bowing down his head and asked to Sukadeva Goswami. He asked questions to Sukadeva Goswami. Same two questions. What is the duty of people in general? And what is the duty of a dying man? So these two questions are asked and then Shukadeva Goswami starts giving answers. This is another photo. Here you can see clearly, you know, Narada Muni is sitting and Vyasa Maharshi, he is sitting and so many other sages and there is Ganga flowing on the other side. That blue color you can see, that is Ganga flowing on the other side. So in this way, the questions were asked. Specifically, the questions were like this. So it comes here. Yeah, he glorifies Shukadeva Goswami and then he asks questions. Yeah. Atha prichhami sam siddhim योगिनां परमं गुरुं पुरुषस्येह यत्कार्यं रियमानस्य सर्वथा. Can somebody read this translation? Yes, who would like to read?
Prabhuji, can I read again?
Yes, you can read.
You are the spiritual master of great saints and devotees. I am therefore begging you to show the way of perfection for all persons and especially for one who is about to die.
Yeah. So, purushasya yat karyam, what is the duty of a man? And mriyamanasya sarvatha, and especially of a dying man. Yes. Yat shrotavyam atho japyam yat kartavyam yat kartavyam nirvi prabho smartavyam bhajaniyam va bruhi yadva viparyayam. That is asking, yes, shrotavyam, what should I hear? Atho japyam, what should I chant? Yat kartavyam, what should I do? What are my activities? Nirvi prabho smartavyam bhajaniyam va, whom I should remember, smartavyam, and bhajaniyam va, whom I should worship. Please tell me all these things. So he has this another question, right? So then he continues glorifying Shukadeva Goswami in this way, and then he completes the questions. So in this way, the first canto of Srimad Bhagavatam ends. This is the last section of the first canto of Bhagavatam, and then in the next chapter you will see that Shukadeva Goswami starts answering the question. First, he glorifies the question of Parikshit Maharaj. Such a wonderful question you have asked. Your question is wonderful because the answer to this question will bring wonderful, will be beneficial for everybody. That's what he says. Your question is so wonderful that the answer to this question will benefit the entire world. So, Variya Neshate Prashna. This is a beautiful question, he says. Wonderful question. And then he says, the answer to this question is, one should Tasmad Bharata Sarvatma Bhagavan Ishwaro Harihi Shrotavya Kirtitavyascha Smartavyascha Ichchatabhayam. That's the answer, which comes in second canto. I'll open here second canto. First chapter, text number, 5. Can all of you repeat after me this shloka? Maybe you can unmute yourself and you can, I'll recite, then you can follow. Okay. Tasmad Bharata Sarvatma.
Tasmad Bharata Sarvatma.
Bhagavan Vishwaro Hari.
Bhagavan Vishwaro Hari.
Shrotavya Kirtitavyascha.
Shrotavya
Kirtitavyascha.
Smartavyascheccetavayam. Can somebody read this translation?
O descendant of King Bharat, one who desires to be free from all miseries must hear about, glorify, and also remember the personality of Godhead, who is the super soul, the controller, and the savior from all miseries.
Yes. So, Shrotavya means hearing. Kirtitavya means chanting. Smartavya means remembering. So one should chant, one should hear, and one should remember whom? Hari. One should remember Krishna. Then we will become fearless. We will not have any fear of death. Those who forget Krishna will have fear. Those who remember Krishna will not have any fear. That's the meaning of this. So everybody in this world should do these three things. Hear about Krishna, chant Krishna's names, and remember Krishna. Right? Is it very easy to do, right? Right? In our 21-day challenge, in our bring out the best in you, we are given the challenge of chanting at least 5 minutes. Or from today, it will be one round of chanting Hare Krishna. So in that way, people can chant, hear, and also remember Krishna. And when you chant Krishna, then you'll also have to think about Krishna, isn't it? So all things will happen. So chanting is the most important process. And also hearing lectures like this. When we hear lectures, we also remember Krishna. So in this way, all things are accomplished. These three things are accomplished by chanting and attending classes. So it's the main thing to do, right? So we should plan our day in such a way that we get time for chanting. We should allocate some time for chanting every day, like all of you are already doing. And we should also allocate time for hearing some Krishna Katha every day, like this, Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya. So weekly once we are meeting like this, but apart from this, on everyday basis, we can also hear some lectures, right? Nowadays, so many lectures are available. And we'll also share you some playlist, which you can take and hear on a regular basis. That will keep us Krishna conscious. So that's what we have to do. So in general, everybody has to do this, but a dying man, what he has to do? That's given here. एतावान् सांख्य योगाभ्याम् स्वधर्म परिनिष्ठया जन्मलाभः परपुंसाम् अन्ते नारायण स्मृतिः अन्ते नारायण स्मृति अंत काल में नारायण का स्मरण करना चाहिए. सो दैट इज द सॉल्यूशन गिवन हियर. कैन समबडी रीड दिस ट्रांसलेशन?
मैं प्रभु जी.
प्लीज रीड.
Prabhuji, am I audible?
Yes, audible. Raghunath.
Yeah. The highest perfection of human life achieved either by complete knowledge of matter and spirit, by practice of mystic powers, or by perfect discharge of occupational duty is to remember the personality of Godhead at the end of life.
Yes. So one should remember Krishna at the time of death. So this is the... We have to practice remembering Krishna throughout life. Then at the time of death, we'll be able to remember Krishna. Right? So that's what Shukadeva Maharaj says. And then Shukadeva Maharaj says, now I will train you how to remember Krishna. So now you have 7 days. 7 days, and I'll continuously, you sit here, I'll continuously speak Srimad Bhagavatam, and then you can prepare your consciousness to remember Krishna. So Parikshit Maharaj asks further questions, and Shukadeva Goswami starts answering questions. And in these 7 days, lot of Krishna Katha happens. First canto, second canto, up to 12th canto, lot of discussions come. They discuss about all the avatars, all the devotees, all the concepts of creation, maintenance, destruction, structure of the universe, and God, how God created everything. So all that is very nicely described. And the ultimate thing is Krishna's pastimes, which come in the 10th canto. So that is the culmination of Krishna Katha. So in that way, 7 days passed. And after 7 days, Parikshit Maharaj had completely absorbed his mind in Krishna, and he sat in meditation. And then I had shared the, I think, PowerPoint with all of you, the poster. In that you will see that one snake bird is coming and biting Parikshit. And when it bites, along with the poison, fire also comes. And fire starts burning Parikshit Maharaj. But Parikshit Maharaj is peaceful. He is fully absorbed in Krishna. And his body burnt to ashes, but his soul entered into spiritual world and attained the service of Krishna in the spiritual world. Right? In this way, he was not afraid of death. But if you don't remember Krishna, then we'll be afraid of death. So we have to practice remembering Krishna in the life, so that at the time of death, we'll be able to remember Krishna. Then we can leave our body like Parikshit Maharaj. So you have to learn the art of living and art of leaving, both. Art of living is practice Krishna consciousness, and art of leaving is remember Krishna at the time of death. In these two ways, one can perfect one's life. So that's what this pastime teaches us. Right? And Parikshit Maharaj went back to world, and his son Janamejaya, he became the king. Then he continued ruling the kingdom. So in this way, Srimad Bhagavatam appeared, and that Bhagavatam was written down by sages of Naimisharanya. Vasudeva wrote down the version of Suta Goswami speaking to sages of Naimisharanya. And that is available to all of us in the form of Srimad Bhagavatam. And we can read the Srimad Bhagavatam and perfect our life. And in this course of our online courses, we'll be discussing more pastimes from Srimad Bhagavatam. Weekly once, we'll meet and we'll discuss. Okay? Anybody has any quick question? We can take maybe one question. If you can switch on your videos, that will be much better. We can see each other. We're meeting after a long time.
Prabhuji, I have one question. As you have told that by by after our death or something, we are burnt to ashes, and then that ashes are mixed in the Ganga. We are liberated.
Yeah.
What happens to the karma?
Liberated. At that one gets a better destination. One can get liberated only if the heart is pure.
Yes, sir. That's what one question was. And another thing is, what about the karma he imbibes?
Yeah. Suppose he is going to hell, then that going to hell may be prevented. Not taking back home back to Godhead. So for going back to Godhead, one should be fully pure in his heart. Just by mechanically taking bath in Ganga, one should take bath in devotion. So activity is good, but along with that activity, we should also have the right intention. Activity and intention both has to be done. Then only it will be helpful.
Prabhuji?
Yes.
I am chanting daily and I want to get rid of some bad habit like laziness.
Okay.
I am trying, but at one point of time, I was like, okay, today is enough. I will postpone this one today for today. How to get rid of that, Prabhuji?
Yeah, so actually lethargy, we have to overcome by making a routine of doing, making a habit of doing things on time. Otherwise, we keep on procrastinating. One of the symptoms of laziness is procrastination. Whatever is supposed to be done today, we'll do it tomorrow. Or keep on postponing to the right, to the last moment. So instead of that, one should make a plan that allocate, okay, chanting this time, reading this time, office work this time, and family work this time. And we should try to stick as much as possible to that. A little bit here and there it may happen, but that's okay. But at least we have made a gross schedule which we can follow, isn't it? So we can have a smart card, a kind of a chart, which we can maintain for ourselves. We can make time slots and what activity you're going to do in the time slot, and then try to follow it. And you keep trying, you may fail a little bit, but again, keep trying. And after a few weeks or months, you will see that, yes, your schedule has come back on track. Today, I got an email from one of the Bring Out the Best in You participants. He said, Prabhuji, I'm sleeping 9:30 every day and I'm getting up early. I'm doing so many other household activities. She's a lady. She's taking care of two grandsons also. She's an elderly lady. She's attending our youth program. But she said, I'm feeling energetic and I'm eating before sunset and following all the things which are mentioned in the life schedule. And it is helping me very much, like that she has written. So it takes time. For some, it may be very fast, but for some, it may take time. But don't give up. Keep trying, it will come. And a proper routine will set for you.
Thank you.
Keep trying. Don't give it up. Remember the spider story. Spider and the king. Spider is trying to make the web, but it is falling again and again. But finally, he made it. Similarly, he also gave it. And another thing is, you should have many, many activities to do. If there's no activity, then your mind will become lazy and maybe may go to sleep. You should have a list of activities, to-do list. If you don't have any activities, then you should go and ask some service. Many of our volunteers are involved in this service of online. Only about 15, 20 of them are engaged. So there are so much things. They were launching children's program. Did you get the information of that?
Yeah, about writing, chanting, and storytelling.
Yeah.
Seen the post on Facebook.
Facebook, right?
Yeah, Facebook. Yes.
I'll share it with all of you also. We are starting a thinking program also. You can have some engagement. Like you can propagate such kind of children's activities online. I'm sharing this here. And we'll put it in the bottom. So we can help people to, for children to participate in this. We can have some active engagement. Our laziness is overcome. My life is so busy that morning to night, there are so many things to do. Sessions will be there at 45 minutes. We had about 4 sessions. This is the fourth one. And there's the difference between speed. Shambhu and then there are many other temples like this. So this time for so we can make it clean like that. We can take some stories from it. So, and also one more thing is that we are doing Japa Yajna.
108 crores.
Yeah, so this 4 months of Chaturmasa, we are doing 108 crore Japa Yajna campaign. So 16 July it started up to 25th. All of you can also participate in this. Here's the link. I will share this on the website. You can start go there and keep entering your scores. Whatever you are chanting, you enter. 4 on 8 on. You are chanting, keep it on a regular basis. And today is 25th of July. So from 15 July to 16th to 25th July, whatever rounds you have done, you add it together. And from tomorrow onwards, you can add it daily or you can add on weekly basis also. It's up to you. But this will help us to propagate the holy name everywhere, and you can connect your friends or somebody who's interested. You just chant one round and enter your name. Daily you chant one round. Like that you can inspire them and let them put their scores here. And when they put their scores, now we already have crossed about 1.5 lakh. It already have crossed. So daily basis it can improve, and then we'll be able to reach this target of 108 crores. Right? So you can take some engagements like this, which can help you. So Vaishali Mata is asking that what about karmic account? At the time of death, we are carrying it forward, or at the time of death it is nullified. Yeah, and if you become fully pure, karmic account is nullified. So, but if you're not fully purified, if you're not done bhakti, then whatever karma remains, it's carried forward to the next life. And based upon our karma, we'll get the next life. So that is the fact. So karma goes to the next life. But if you have done bhakti so nicely, you have chanted Hare Krishna so nicely that all karma is destroyed, then no more next life. We get elevation to Krishna's planet. We don't get birth again in this material world. Right? That is the answer. And that's the goal of life, to make our karma account zero and to increase our bhakti account, love for Krishna. Then we go back to God. Okay. So, thank you very much for your questions and coming together like this. So, mostly one more week we'll have to come at this time, 4:30 to 5:30. So, maybe next Saturday also because of this evening programs. Bring out the best in you. That will be ending. But now Janmashtami is coming next month, so a lot of activities are there. So all of you can also participate in those services. Like this 108 crore Japa Yajna is one, children's contests are one. And we are also doing some online event, Janmashtami event, because people cannot come to temple. Not many will come. So we are doing online event. So if you're interested, you can participate in those online events. And if you want, you can connect more people to these online events. So sitting at their home, they can participate in Janmashtami programs. So more information will be given in the time to come. Okay. Yeah. And for ladies like Vaishali Mataji, Anita Mataji, and even our Subhashini Mataji and others, there is also a separate group of ladies events happening, which is happening weekly and daily also. So I was thinking I will introduce you to that group also. Then it will be here. Sometimes you can join that group and see what's happening. And they have their kids programs going on, and you will meet people of your own age. Like there are many boys here in our group, but you will also be able to meet your people of your own age and with whom you can connect to and take more further guidance. And that will be what's happening. So we will personally share some details of that group with both of you. Then you can connect to them. Then that will be more helpful in your spiritual progress. Okay. So we'll be doing that soon. Within 1 or 2 days, we'll send you the contacts. There are about 30 Mataris who come together on a daily basis and do varieties of activities. So we'll connect you to that group also. Hare Krishna. So thank you so much for joining us, and we'll meet again next time.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thank you.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Hare Krishna, Kedar. Hare Krishna.